best. More exciting than seeing two fighters in their prime slugging it out. And that's what this is all about. We all remember the great fights. Brian mentioned some of them, the past. And we just love watching the Diego Corrales Castillos, the Gotti Wards, and so many other just classic brawls. Added to that list of epic brawls between two warriors taking things to a whole other level. This fight will be a candidate for Fight of the Year, if not the Fight of the Year in 2023. This is a fight you don't want to miss. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Let me bring to the podium now one of the men who was certainly very instrumental in bringing this mega fight to fruition. He's the president of sports, then programming for Showtime Network, Mr. Steven Espinoza.
Thank you, Brian. Appreciate Brian coming cross country. He's one of the busiest men in sports television nowadays. You see him on just about every network, but we're thrilled that he's been a part of Showtime Championship Boxing for so long. I'm going to be brief. As Brian said, you can usually tell the quality of a fight because it's inversely proportional to the amount of hype and hyperbole that people say. The harder people try to convince you that it's an excellent fight, the more likely it's not. Well, I'm not going to try and convince you anything, because if you know anything about boxing, you know this is one of the very best fights that can be made in the sport. The consensus, number one and number two contenders in this division, this is a high stakes matchup, personally and professionally. As Brian mentioned, the pay-per-view will be distributed by Showtime Pay-Per-View, start time of 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific. There will be an all-access, of course. The Emmy Award-winning series will premiere on March 10th at 7:30 p.m. Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. Just a couple of words about these two fighters. David Benavidez, called the Mexican Monster by none other than Mike Tyson. Some of the fastest hands in the heavier divisions and in the sport overall. This will be the eighth time he's fought on Showtime, and he's grown up on Showtime. He first caught our eye on Showbox way back in 2015. Since then, he's fought on Special Editions, he's fought on Championship Boxing. And this will be his first appearance on a pay-per-view. He's been on the stage so long that it's easy to forget that he's only 26 years old. He's the youngest ever champion at 168 pounds at the tender age of 20 years old. And he is one of the most entertaining fighters in all the sport. As for Caleb, this will be his third appearance on Showtime, his second on Showtime pay-per-view. He is an excellent boxer, fundamentally solid, underrated power. It's coming off what, for many people, including CBS Sports and boxing scene, ranked as the 2022 knockout of the year. Highlight reel knockout of Anthony Durrell. A very durable Anthony Durrell. And if you have any doubts about Caleb Plant's power, go back and watch that highlight, and you won't. The last time Caleb fought on Showtime pay-per-view against Canelo Alvarez, and there are many people who thought that he provided a blueprint, frustrated very long, and it's that combination of skills and power that makes him a worthy adversary for David Benavidez. You know, as Tom says, and I've spoken about this before, it seems like many times in this sport, people want to pay more attention to the fights that don't get made than the fights that do. Well, this is an outstanding fight. And more importantly, neither one of these two fighters had to take it. This is not a mandatory, it's not an eliminator, it's not something that anyone had to be talked into. This is something that each of these two fighters wanted personally, professionally. And again, boxing got it right, as it often does.